Hi everyone, this is Reality Scoop, and I will be reviewing Season 14, Episode 5 of Sister Wives. The episode is called A Not So Merry Christmas, and I have a confession to make. I love this episode. It was so good, and I don't know if it's because I had a glass of wine before watching it, but it was great, so let's get to it. So the episode starts, and we're only a few hours after the weird Christmas Eve presentation about the big house, so everyone's a little bit still on edge about that, but everyone's gathered in Mary's living room in her rental, the huge rental with the waterfall inside and the elevator. Meanwhile, Janelle and Christine have way bigger families, and they can't even fit the family in there, so we all have to go to Mary's house. Everyone has the same pajama bottoms because I think that's a tradition. And we learn that Robin loves Christmas so much, and she's so upset that Cody brought up this whole issue. She's pissed. They start to wonder, you know, which adult child is gonna move to Flagstaff? Is it gonna be Maddie? Cody thinks it's gonna be Maddie because her husband likes deer in the backyard or something like that. But they're all kind of hoping that the adult kids are going to move to Flagstaff. And in reality, you know, they're probably not going to move to Flagstaff. So I'm sorry, guys. It's not going to happen. And then, like, probably one of my favorite moments of the episode, Hunter's like, "Thank you for conceiving me on Christmas." And then Janelle starts to blush and everyone's like, "Oh, I guess Hunter was conceived on Christmas and we didn't know this." And then, you know, Christine's trying to make light of the situation, but that's a really awkward moment for all the wives. And then suddenly we hear ominous music and Cody asks if anyone wants to see the plans for the new house. Christine makes me laugh so hard because I do this too. This is what she said.
"I'm busy cleaning the kitchen."
That's right. Christine and Robin just pretend they're busy. They're in the kitchen. They're busy. They have no time to gather around the table. But Janelle and Cody and a few of the adult kids just gather and they're looking at the plan so intently. Then there's suddenly a flashback, and I love flashbacks. We learn that in Lehi, Robin was excited to live in that big house where all the wives lived. She said it was like idyllic and she wanted that experience. She actually even says that, "Oh, I had options to be monogamous. I chose to be in this plural family." And then she also drops another bomb that says, well, she learned from some of the wives that maybe Lehi kind of sucked. So then she was like, "Oh, well, maybe I don't want that." Then we see Mary in the confessional, and she doesn't want to say if she's for or against the big house. She's on the outs, so she doesn't want to rock the boat, obviously. She says she has strong opinions, and I swear that that opinion is that she does not want to live in that big house, but, you know, that's just what I think. What do you guys think? Okay, so I love Christine in this episode. In the next confessional, she's really honest and she's just laying it all out there. She explains that she can't be the wife she wants to be in terms of intimacy when they're all in a big house because you have to be so careful if the other wife's around. You can't, like, be affectionate. And she does not like that. She enjoys her privacy with Cody, I guess. And then Janelle has her own confessional where she drops another bomb that we didn't know. She says that in Lehi, Christine used to live under another wife. And that is not a healthy thing for polygamous families because when you live under a wife's household, you can hear things from the top. You can hear them laughing. You can, God knows what you can hear, but it's not healthy. And with Christine's jealousy streak, I know that would not be a good thing. Oh, and actually, Maddie's pregnant again. We know this because there's like a big reveal on Christmas, and it just shows how long this happened because Maddie's baby is like 5 months old. Following this, there's a dramatic meeting. And Janelle has to talk to the wives about something important. She's dressed really officially in like a suit. And she tells them that, you know, she's been going to Vegas every weekend and the houses are not selling. She proposes they need to drop in price by 40 grand. And everything goes quiet. Christine has a confessional where she's like, you know, like, if I had a broker, I'd like to talk to him privately instead of it being like a family issue that's just like put out there. And I kind of get that. No one really wants to drop the price of their home, and it's not really a good day for Janelle to have to like drop this on everybody. Robin gets really upset because the thing that sold her onto moving to Flagstaff was that they were going to have all this equity from the homes and have all this money, and it was kind of like a selling point for her. And now everything's just switched, and Cody is like, well, that was 9 months ago. Now we just need to get rid of the homes. And she's like, why is he like Jekyll and Hyde? Like, it's so different. She's the first one to leave from that meeting. She just like puts on her boots super quickly, I noticed. And so she storms out, everybody leaves, and Cody wants to talk to Mary of all people, the wife that he doesn't even like cohabitate with or like that much. And I like seeing how, you know, it's Mary and Cody again. They're actually talking and Cody's opening up. He needs to take something off his chest, and he basically starts to reminisce about how their Lehigh house sold for half what it was worth. He's worried. And Mary, cue confessional, where she's like, she thinks he's scared. She thinks he's gonna look like an idiot, and he's in full panic mode. I agree, Mary. I totally agree. She also said he's going down the rabbit hole. He also confesses that originally he wanted to move back to St. George, Utah. And now Mary wants to talk to Janelle and have Cody there too. I don't know what they're going to talk about. But then there's a confessional, and Cody says now that he lacks faith and they've gambled with hope, but now they're struggling. And it's just kind of sad, guys. I just want things to end well. All right, everyone. So I can't wait until next week. Please tune in and please, please, please subscribe to my channel. It would mean so much to me. Have a great night.